All right, thanks a lot, Michelle. There is a new craze around journaling, and here to explain why is speaker and author Rich Bracken. Hey, Rich, good
How's
to see you.
Good to see you, Nick.
Hey, nice gray suit today.
I appreciate that.
Why has this become such a craze recently?
You know, the self-care craze is really starting to ramp up. So over last year, the Americans have seen a 39% increase in anxiety. A 39% increase in 1 year is tremendous. But on the flip side of that, the self-care craze has actually ramped up just as equally. So there is an app that has been tracking all the app purchases for self-care specifically. That's gone up 170%. So people are very aware of it, and journaling is actually the easiest way to get into self-care.
All right, let's talk about its health benefits right now.
Sure.
And we're going to use our board right here, and let's start here. What are the first things we need to look at here?
So we'll talk a little bit about the different ways that you can use the journaling for some of the health benefits. Some of the health benefits at Intermountain Healthcare, which is one of the top healthcare systems in the country, they've talked about reduced stress. They've talked about improved immune function, when actually you can lower your increase the time of healing on any kind of injuries and wounds, but you can also keep your memory sharp and increase your memory capacity and boost your mood, which is actually seen higher in men that journal, because what happens? We don't typically talk about our emotions,
right?
So when we can journal, we see a higher increase, although both sexes see an increase in boosted mood.
All right, so help us get started here. How do we get started?
Sure, there's two main ways to get started into journaling. So when you think about free-form journaling, that's when you get a book that's blank page, you just sit down and start writing, kind of your old diary approach, maybe not as...
Or maybe brainstorming, it's just whatever is on top
exactly,
of your mind, and just let
exactly.
it, just whatever it is.
Nothing's too silly.
No rules.
No rules.
No mistakes.
No rules whatsoever. The only time you don't have any rules, right then in journaling. So making sure that nothing is too short, nothing is too long, nothing's too silly, but just get your emotions out. But there are also guided journals. Some of the top leaders in the country, Rachel Cruz, Mel Robbins, they're all coming out with guided journals, which give you prompts, questions, topics that you can use to start bringing some of those emotions and those thoughts out if you have a hard time just free-forming.
Okay, let's show some of the methods then.
Sure, so I will talk about my handwriting style first. It is not that great, which makes me a great journaler because I keep my emotions to myself. So let's talk about the GLAD theory. So we'll talk about the GLAD theory. G stands for gratitude. So what are you gracious for? Something that you can write on a daily basis, and that's my wonderful spelling of gratitude.
That's gracious.
I am gracious for my handwriting, that nobody can read it. Also, something that you've learned. What have you learned that day? Something that you appreciate. So we'll get into appreciation. And then if you talk about something that has delighted you, what has made you really, really happy? So write those things down. That's a great way of starting. Hopefully your handwriting is better than mine, but it's a really good way to get those thoughts out, to start diving into your emotions and start being more self-aware.
What will you discover? I've done an example of this. It's a little bit different than this right here. It's called a gratitude list here.
Yes.
When you're feeling blue and you're feeling down here, but you get done with that gratitude list.
Yes.
And you feel different.
You do.
That's the goal here, isn't it?
It is exactly the goal. And really what it is, and when we talk about nothing is too silly, nothing's too shallow, it could be, hey, I got out of bed the first time my alarm went off. That's something that you did really well that day. But speaking on and writing on those things that you're really gracious for and that you've learned that day, bring out those positive emotions. And it's building that habit and building the momentum to being a more positive, balanced, emotionally intelligent person.
And you'll also be able to identify your personal inventory, also yourself too. So it's
exactly like I need to go take some handwriting lessons immediately. I've now learned that. So that's my L for the day.
You did well,
thank
Rich.
You.
Great to see you. You can get more tips from Rich on his podcast and on social media. He has links to it all on his website, richbracken.com.